What's good? What's good? Welcome to Epic Entertainment. Critics, I'm Antoine.
I'm still James.
And we got an epic trailer reaction for y'all today. We got the Stranger Things 4. Season 4. Yeah. Sorry. Season 4. Something that probably they only made one season of, but somehow stretched it to 4. I mean, because after that first one, it was a pretty good, it was a good
there was
nostalgia trip, good series, but it clearly was designed to be done.
Yeah.
I mean, what you think? You think
part of it is, and this is kind of the weakness of like stuff that's made with some aspect of that nostalgia. It's like after the third dose of nostalgia, I no longer care about the nostalgia.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I was almost they was losing me in the second season.
Yeah.
Because it was the point of it was fun. The 80s is in right now.
I'm talking about the third dose in the first season.
Oh.
part of it is I wasn't around in the 80s, so I'm already not feeling that nostalgia. But also I don't like getting like purposefully hit in nostalgia. Mm-hmm. Like it's one thing for it to be set there so we're going to own up to it. But once it's clear that you're trying to make sure that I get the nostalgia, I start feeling like you're trying to manipulate me.
I mean, right. But also I think it's a love letter to, because those kind of movies was huge in the 80s.
Yes, yeah.
So it was kind of like
Goonies, E.T.
Right. Explorers, you know,
yeah.
It's a lot of them. And that was kind of like a love letter to that genre.
Which works for the first season.
Right, exactly. Like that's what I said. After that, then I'm like, okay.
Like one good thing I will say for the second season was less that and more the consequences of the first season.
Yeah.
Then you get to the third and it's just like, why are we still here?
Yeah, right. And it got to a point of you said something, you did something in that first season. It could have been like a movie, but you stretched out to be a show, and it actually was successful doing it that way. And then it's like you said, why are we still here? You ain't got nothing, but you keep going back.
Because like, even that third season, like they made it very clear they didn't have much of a story to tell. So it's just, you know, Eleven's tired of.
Well, the thing is, it would be cool if it played off like an anthology or something, where maybe not anthology, but in this universe.
Or even a Creature of the Week.
Right, we're in this universe, but we're following new characters that's being put in a situation that's not just a similar situation, but whatever the threat is, moved on to more different people. Because it don't make sense that these same people keep on fighting the threat.
Well, like they even make that.
These are normal people now.
Yeah, they even made a good chunk of that third season. You know, Eleven's just trying to figure herself out. That's it.
She's right. I mean, Eleven got power, so that's the only one that needs to
like,
beat her.
But it's like, it's not even her figuring out her powers. It's her figuring out what kind of clothes does she want to wear? How does she like her hair?
Right. Well, I mean, because, you know, she didn't have no childhood or something.
Which is fine to make that a part of the story, but it became the story.
Right. It's her show. They should just call it Eleven. And she been blowing up Millie Bobby Brown.
Yeah.
And so now it's just like her show. Which it was, she was kind of the main star, but it was like all of them. Now it's just 11.
It's her.
But honestly, I think it's overstaying its welcome. But let's see this trailer before I say that. Stranger Things season 4 trailer. Yeah, action.
You've broken everything.
Nightmare Elm Street now.
Your suffering is almost at an end.
Dear Billy, I don't know if you can even hear this.
Who's Billy? Is that her brother?
Ever since you left, everything's been a total disaster.
I don't think he died, though.
For a while, we tried to be happy.
You're a cheerleader bat.
Normal.
Oh, is he a basketball player?
I know, that's impossible.
I think a basketball player.
To get a cheerleader. You know what?
Located you guys far from Hawkins because I thought you'd be safe. A war is coming. I'm afraid your friends at Hawkins are very much in the eye of the storm.
I don't have my powers.
How to say this other than just to say it. Without you, we can't win this war.
See you on the other side.
On the other side.
I was convinced I was put here for some other reason. Maybe I can still help, even if it's the last thing I do.
People say Hawkins is cursed. They're not way off.
They broke it up to two values. Just let you know it's gonna be a minute on that. So yeah. What you think, man?
Yeah.
It looks like I got some interesting stuff in there, but the thing is, it's like this been pushed way beyond where it started. Yeah.
Like
I tell you what, these kids getting too old. I mean, they might as well just say this is the 90s.
Yeah.
Because all of them look like they're about 16 now.
Yeah. I don't care about the kids anymore. I don't even care about 11 anymore, to be perfectly honest. It feels like they're forcing everything back into the same situation it was in.
Yeah.
Just because, like, that's where they're comfortable.
They can all just move and just, like, live somewhere else. They don't have to come back to the situation.
Yeah. It's like,
that's why I say it could be an anthology.
Or even to the point of saying, the weird stuff still happens in that town. They've moved on, yeah, and someone else is in it now.
But we got to handle this because we the mystery team. Yeah. But okay, what they copying off of? Because they might as well stop saying homage and just start saying we copy it. What they copying off of? Or should I say, what author should they be like? Hey. You mind if we borrow a...
Look, I'm not saying Stephen
just,
King...
Just like
I'm
it.
Not saying Stephen King needs a royalty check, but he might deserve a
he
writing...
He got enough of those.
Yeah, he might need a writing credit.
I'd be like, look, I'd be like, well, you know what? Go ahead and donate that to charity.
Yeah.
But you ain't going to just do that without giving me something.
And I better not see no turtle in there either.
They copied off it like a like heavy.
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. Really?
And I saw someone saying that your final boss there with the creepy voice
spider
over,
dude.
Yeah, somebody
who
was saying.
This guy?
So in the same way
he
that
like he been here or something.
Yeah.
Like we so know
the same
you.
Way
know
they.
Y'all know me. I don't know that fool.
So in the same way that the Demogorgon comes from like,
he from the same.
Well, no.
Mentioned the
the way that was originally something that was in their D&D game and turned out to be a real thing on the other side. He's supposed to be an evil god from D&D
Oh.
Named Vecna. At least that's one of the theories I've heard so far.
Oh.
I don't know how serious that is or if there's any...
He talking like, you know, like we know about him and we just... Now we just seeing... Like, we don't know you.
like that's kind of
I have arrived. Nobody's waiting on you, man. Who are you?
Like, you've broken everything. So now I gotta get your ass.
You've been waiting on my arrival. And now, who are you? I am. Allow myself to introduce myself. Like, all right, man, look, I'm tired of this.
But, like, that's kind of the problem with this show, right? It's like, if you want any of the monsters to have provenance, you kind of have to pretend there's provenance, even though there isn't any.
Well, I mean, the thing is, I mean, it was good. It was a good look. It looked, you know, he looked freaking scary.
And I'm
all
sure
that.
This would be great if we read the comic.
Right, but...
But we
no,
don't.
Right, but it ain't no... Oh, was this supposed to be based on... Did they
Stranger Things was a graphic novel.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought this was original.
Or a straight-up comic book, one of these two.
Oh, I thought it was all original property.
No, this was a comic. This was made by the... I could be wrong. My understanding...
Why are you saying it?
You know what? You're right. Before we get any comments on that, I was going to say... I thought it might have been.
But you know it's a graphic. You know it was.
It was like a comic book.
Okay.
So, like, I think it might have been made by the same guy that made Walking Dead.
I always thought it was an original property.
Yeah, no. This was a comic.
Okay. Yeah. Well, whatever. It looked like some interesting stuff there. I mean, we know that the sheriff was taken to the other dimension. I thought he was taken to the other dimension or something. I don't know.
I mean, he's stuck in Gulag right now. So
right, he in Russia, ain't he?
Yeah.
He's just the rated guardian. Like, oh, goodness.
He cannot get out of Siberia, man.
He ain't even Russian.
David Harbour's just stuck in Siberia, man. He can't get out.
Right. But no, you know, it's some stuff there, but, I mean, y'all kind of know. It's to a point, if you still going to do this little kid stuff, they just getting too old for that. They tall now, like, what's the black kid named? Lucas, I think.
Yeah, Lucas? That sounds right.
He looked 22. He got a mustache and he tall now. It's like, man, look, y'all can't do this little kid stuff no more.
Yeah.
You know?
what's your one boy, the chubby one? He ain't chubby no more.
The one with the no teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look like he trying to put on some muscle or something.
Right. I mean, they hit puberty. That's why they do this on shows. If you got somebody that's 12, and that's when the first one started, by the time they 16, they're going to look totally different.
Yeah, yeah. Well, like, and that's kind of the problem.
They might do a time skip just to...
I mean, I hope they do.
Make that make sense.
But again, we'd be
in
the
90s. They still
trying
to get us the 80s stuff. It's 1986. Hey, like... No. This ain't the next year.
It is 1992 and you
right.
know it.
Man, y'all better be listening to the Chronic on this one. Y'all can't don't give me that.
You know what? What's his name would listen to that, wouldn't he?
What's that?
No Teeth.
No, I forget his name.
I cannot remember his name, but he seemed like the kind of dude that would gravitate to that sort of thing.
Right. They should be in high school. You know,
it looked like they might be.
Right, and that's like the whole point it seems like they're trying to keep that they got us stuck on the Goonies.
Yeah.
And that was cool for the first season.
Was it just
now you need to move on.
Later on in the trailer, was there someone on the other side playing a guitar? Like
It looked like.
What the hell is that?
I don't know. We'll have to see. Like, maybe that was a dream or something.
Don't get me wrong. I'd love to see that heavy metal video that they stole that
I know,
from.
That's what it looked like.
Look like something straight out of a Dio video or something.
Yeah.
But I don't know what the hell is going on.
Maybe that was a dream sequence. Yeah. Who knows?
That's the other problem with this trailer. Who knows?
Yeah. I mean, I want to see it. It looks cool. But the thing is, I kind of wish they just introduce new characters and keep the same concept but with different characters. Yeah. Not that I don't like those guys. I liked all the characters from the original. It's just time to move on.
Yeah. Four seasons deep.
Yeah. Well, we'll see. We'll see where it go. But that's it, man. It looked cool. I want to see it. It's two volumes. That's how they do every now. They break it. I kind of appreciate that because when they they put too many, like they used to do 13, everything, yeah. 13.
Well, like, hopefully.
No matter how much material they got, you're getting 13.
Hopefully breaking it up, like they can actually tell a more cohesive story with what they got. Since you got to have, like, have a good stopping point before on the first volume before you get to the next one. So.
Yeah, well, we'll see. Yeah. Looks cool. It's coming out May 27th. That's next month. We'll get a review for that volume one up. We'll do both volumes, but we'll get the review for that volume one up and let you know what we think about it. So we're going to be out here. Anybody checking out the video, please subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon so you get alerts every time we post new videos or we live stream.
And don't forget, if you like what you've seen here today, hit that thumbs up down below. And feel free to leave a comment if you know more about what's probably going on in this season than we do, because, again, we're not.
Yeah, who's the spider dude?
Yeah, let us know, y'all.
I know you've been waiting for my arrival.
We are really curious.
Nobody ain't waiting on you two.
Like, we might do our own research, but we'd like to hear what you have to say.
Yes, we out of here.
Peace.